What is the poorest country in the world?
Africa.
What is the poorest country in the world?
Africa.
What is the poorest country in the world?
Africa.
What is the poorest country in the world?
Probably Africa.
Is the poorest country in the world?
Africa.
The continent.
Yes.
That's wrong.
Oh, these are the people that we think they are better than us. These are the people that black people worship so much. These are the people that black people think they are very intelligent. These are the same people that we think their education is better than us. These are the people that we see as small gods, the whites. Now, they have been asked that which is the poorest country in the world, and a number of them are saying Africa. First of all, Africa is not a country. Africa is a continent with more than 54 countries, you know. 54 countries in them, but they will say, they are saying Africa is the poorest country. And the reason why I've decided to react on this video is just to open minds or to open eyes of Africans and black people who think that they are not worth it in front of the white people. Of course we are. We are here in Africa, all of us trying to learn about Europe countries, Asian countries, you know, North American countries. We know like each and every country in the white and their capital cities. But for them, they only learn about one thing. The one thing they are being taught in the education system is how to exploit Africa. Is how to rob from Africa. That's all they, you know, they are learning about. Most of them, not all of them. But the system, their system is only teaching them one thing. Africa is one country and has a lot of resources. And the resources belong to us, the white. That's what they are being taught. They are not being taught about different countries in you know, in Africa. Unless individual decides to educate, but the system, the education system is teaching the white people that Africa is one country with a lot of resources that belong to the whites. But here in our school, in our education system, we are teaching our black children, our African children, that Africa has 54 countries and each and every country is by its own. We have borders that we need to respect. We have languages in each country. This country is better than Nigeria. Kenya is better than this one. Ethiopia is better than Eritrea. Somalia is better than Sudan. We are teaching our children about how South Africa and Nigerians are not the same. But the white people who are exploiting our Africa, they are teaching their children about Africa being one. They don't know about all of these countries in Africa, most of them, unless they visit Africa, unless individual visit Africa and will know it is, there is Tanzania, there is this, but we here in Africa, we think that they are first priority. I'm not saying all of them, there are some of good white people, but most of them, more so the one who have this corrosive mind to think that Africa is theirs. More so those who are racist, they think being black is bad. Those who think that they are the first priority, you know. But our education system in Africa needs to change. And we need to tell our children that these borders were kept there by a pen to divide and rule. Because the upper side, they wanted to rule the British, they wanted to rule the France, the Spanish wanted to rule, and Germany wanted to rule. What I'm trying to say, the education system is designed to belittle Africa. The education system of theirs is designed to make them know Africa is a poor country. Their media only showcase the bad side of Africa. They don't showcase the best side of Africa. Their media and the education system, all of them are designed to showcase Africa as one country and Africa as a place where it's, you know, it's very poor. And I just want to open the minds of the youths. We have a lot of youths here in Africa, more so, for example, in Kenya. They think they're going to make it big when they are maybe in Europe. They're going to make it big when they are not in Africa, that Africa will only drag you back. They believe, I see most of them are, you know, waiting for these visas. They're applying for green card because they want to go to the white man's land because it's a greener pasture than Africa. But at a brighter side, or another, at the other side, youths, as we are fighting to go to the white man's land to make it big, but we don't make our Africa better. We will go and we'll come back the same Africa. We'll leave our families, our cousins and sisters will be in the same Africa. So we need to find a way to change how Africa looks, to change how Africa is. We need to look a way to showcase the better side of Africa. We need to look a way to make sure that the world know that Africa is best. And the only way is by accepting. The only way is by talking about Africa, accepting Africa. It's just by, you know, embracing Africa. But the people that we see, they are good, better than us, they are these ones saying they don't know even a country in Africa. I know a country called Kazakhstan. I know a country called Chile. I know a country, Mexico. I know a lot of countries. But they don't know a country in Africa. They just know Africa as one poorest country in the world. Does that tell you anything as a youth of Africa? Because the youth of Africa, we are educated. And we at least we are born in an era where we are not colonized. So we are free to learn and to explore and to know that Africa, we have this and this. We have Big Five. We have resources. We can plant. We can mine. You know, we have lakes. And it's enough for us to create something better and bigger for us. Because I see documentary, for example, in Congo. I see documentary in Senegal. I see documentaries of Burkinabe. I see documentaries of Angola. And I understand. I see how Africa is wealthy, you know, from the natural resources. When I see documentaries in countries like China, maybe countries in US, I see documentary of a country like France, Italy, Germany, Russia. I see them a little bit struggling because the climate does not favor maybe planting of certain products, certain crops. But in Africa, literally across Africa, we can plant everything. On the west, we can grow cocoa. On the east, we can grow tea. We can grow rice. We can grow bananas. We can grow at least everything. And that makes us one of the best. And you see, all these white people, more so here in Kenya, they are trying to implement laws that will make sure that they take away our land. Because the laws that are being passed in the parliament, most of them are to, you know, to control the food security in Africa, in Kenya. So the new world order that they are trying to implement, they are trying to first to test it in Kenya, it will make sure that they control everything in Africa. Now, they don't want to control it in a colonial way like they did, like they came in Africa and they enslaved people. No. Now, they are looking a way to colonize Africa in a way that we cannot have a say. If Africa will not open their eyes, if Africans or black people, we won't open our eyes, these people with this new world order, they are trying to find ways to colonize Africa in a way that they will control food, they'll control land, they'll control everything, and will not have a say on it. You go to plant something in your land, you are being told you have to pay renewal fee for the land to be yours. All these things they are keeping out, like housing project, a cheap housing project, all these things is just a way to find a way to grab the lands. So they will take control of agriculture. And once you take control of food security in a certain country, you are the god in that country. So all these people, we think they are best than us. Just see for yourself. I just want you as an African, as a black person, to open your eyes. We try very hard to know how whites are, to know their countries, to know everything about them. But do they know anything about us? Do they even care? They don't. So my message to the people of Africa and all black people, time has come that we have to be better. We need to embrace ourselves. We need to accept ourselves. We need to know black is our color and accept it. And now find ways to conquer the world. Because that's the only way we can go forward. That's the only way we can do these things, man. So, I don't know. This video just made me happy. It made me laugh, not happy, but it made me laugh how we are struggling as black people to embrace the white, the Western culture, the white man's culture, thinking they are very intelligent, they are the best in history, they have created things, they have invented things. Why don't they know about this continent, Africa? Why? It's not that they don't want to, because they are not being taught that one. All they know is that black person is not good. Africa is our land. That's all they know. Their history is revolving Africa's one, not Africa's individual countries. Tell me what you think about this video in the comment section. I am the Kenyan Beast, of course. We are doing it the African way. Let's meet in the next video.